Alright, so the Xbox One X is the most powerful console on the market right now, and it's the first console to support the new 4K Ultra HD Blu-ray format. Now, a few months down the line, you haven't dropped a whole lot in price, and with PlayStation and Sony pumping out huge titles such as God of War and Horizon Zero Dawn, kind of raises the question, is the Xbox One X worth it? Today, I'm gonna answer that. Buckle up, it's gotta be a good one, guys. Woo! Reasons to buy the Xbox One coming up. Welcome back, my friends. Robin here on Chips Media, bringing you the best tips and tools for gaming. On this channel, you'll find PC components, tech gadgets and console accessories, as well as product reviews. If you're interested in that, consider subscribing. In this video, we're gonna talk about whether the Xbox One X is worth it or not. And with that said, let's jump into it. So let's start with the big one, 4K. Obviously, 4K is a new standard. It's here and it is probably going to stay. Now, a lot of people argue that the difference between 4K and 1080p on, let's say, a 50-inch TV sitting on a wall 3 meters from the couch isn't gonna make much of a difference, since our eyes aren't able to see much of a difference that far from the screen. And yeah, that 4K eventually makes more sense on PC, where you're only sitting a few inches from the monitor. And yeah, that is a valid statement. You either need a big screen or yeah, you need to be sitting very close to the TV in order to see this staggering 4x increase in resolution. What's cool about the Xbox One X, whoever, is that since it's more powerful than the previous Xbox, you have the advantage of get higher frame rate, which has for a long time been a strong argument against console gaming by PC gamers around the world for decades now. 30 frames a second is just not good enough. Thankfully, many game developers are now prioritizing frame rate also, which lets you set a higher frame rate on your Xbox One X if you choose to. And how liberating is that, right? With more power comes more responsibility. Don't brag about it. By the way, guys, let me know in the comments, 4K 30 frames a second or 1080p 60 frames a second. Now, if you want my 2 cents, I choose higher frame rate 11 times out of 10, but that's just me. All right, so now to the elephant in the room. So the Xbox One X costs you, as of making this video, around $500, give or take. Now, for $500, can't you just build a PC with the same performance? Now, the short answer is, unfortunately, no, not for the same price. I've made a video called Best Cheap Gaming PC, where I presented the best PC components available right now, around $500. That video includes the latest components available, including AMD's latest generation, Ryzen. So if you wanna know what an equivalent PC would look like, you can find that video down below. Now, due to the recent price increase in RAM and graphics cards, the cost isn't pretty. I'm sorry to say, you won't be able to play Fortnite in 4K on a $500 PC without buying from the used market. The situation should improve when PC component prices begin dropping, but till the market stabilizes, the Xbox One X remains to be the cheapest way to high fidelity 4K gaming. Now, another benefit with the new Xbox One X is its sleek form. Now, I am getting personal, but I think it's nice looking, and it's very quiet as well, by the way. And thanks to the power supply now being built into the case, all that you're left with is a small black box, which you can place either horizontally or vertically with the included vertical stand. Furthermore, the Ultra HD Blu-ray player is pretty dope in itself. It lets you watch the latest 4K movies out there. It's the only console, as of making this video, that does that. Now, another argument I see people make is that why should you upgrade if you don't have a 4K TV? Now, even though you haven't made the upgrade to a new 4K Ultra HD TV, games are still gonna look crispier and nicer, since we have the advantage of something called super sampling, where the Xbox One X downscales the 4K signal to a 1080p signal, which is going to give you better picture quality than what the original Xbox One gives you today. The process is pretty simple. The game renders at a higher resolution and then downscales to fit your screen. This feature can have a huge positive effect on level of detail, clarity, and something called anti-aliasing. Now, on PC, we've seen such tech in specific games such as Shadow of Mordor and The Witcher series, while AMD and Nvidia has both built their tech into their recent graphics card. AMD calls this virtual super resolution, and Nvidia like to call theirs dynamic super resolution. Games on 1080p TVs will get anisotropic filtering and faster loading times on the Xbox One X. Like the Xbox One S, Microsoft's new consoles support glorious high dynamic range visuals. All of these extra visual benefits definitely adds up a much prettier experience in games, even at 1080p. Yet another benefit with the latest console from Microsoft is the AMD FreeSync 2. This allows compatible displays, ones that accept FreeSync, variable refresh rate signals over HDMI, to time their refresh rate to the console's rendering rate and remove the micro stutter that could be seen to this mismatch. Now the 2 at the end basically tells that it works with HDR content as well. Now Robin, that sounds glorious, but I didn't understand a single word of that. Don't worry guys, now to give you a better understanding how this works in real life, Digital Foundry made a video on it. It's pretty amazing, to be honest. You can find that video down below. Now some people have been wondering, what does Xbox One X Enhanced really mean? In general terms, an Xbox One X Enhanced title offers additional visual enhancements that only the Xbox One X can take advantage of. Microsoft hasn't given a full rundown on the program yet, as far as I know, so it is still a little bit unclear if it means anything beyond super sampling, but it does appear to mean something other than support for 4K and HDR. Enhancement may include higher resolutions, faster frame rates, and improved textures. That's what the Microsoft Xbox One Enhanced Game List states. It sounds a little bit confusing, like a mishmash of non-standard, similar to the PlayStation 4 Pro support situation. There is a video of Larry Major Nelson talking about the Xbox One X Enhanced and what it means. If you're interested, guys, that video can be found down below. Now, another thing I see people been wondering, do existing Xbox One accessories work with the Xbox One X? And the answer is that yes, all existing Xbox One and Xbox One S accessories are fully compatible with the Xbox One X. Now, another argument why you should get the Xbox One X is all the exclusives, which are none. Now, right, we got a few good ones, right? Despite being exclusives, you get most of what you expect to see on PC, like Smite, Fortnite, PUBG, Ark, Rocket League, and so on. What I'm most excited for right now, however, is the upcoming games such as Red Dead Redemption 2, which is a console exclusive, unfortunately, but since it's been developed on this generation console, it's going to be a good looking game. By the way, this game, Red Dead Redemption, is coming out on PlayStation 4 as well, just to make it clear. With that said, we do, however, have a couple of exclusives such as Cuphead, Forza Horizon, Forza Motorsport, Gears of War, Halo, but compared to the PlayStation 4, the Xbox is definitely falling a bit short here, with the PS4 exclusives such as God of War 4, Horizon Zero Dawn, and Last of Us. Microsoft definitely has to step up their game, which kind of brings me over to the next point here, the backward compatibility. It feels like Microsoft is looking rather backward than looking forward. That was a bad joke, but I think you get what I mean here, because this shouldn't come as a surprise to anyone that Microsoft has been putting down a freaking ton of time hammering out new titles to the backward compatibility list, which they seem to be quite proud of, and which they should, obviously. But people need exclusive titles also. Why pay for a 4K console if you're only going to play original Xbox games, right? However, that being said, it's pretty cool that you can actually play many of the original Xbox games on this puppy nowadays. Have you ever enjoyed a game on the original Xbox? Yeah, get the Xbox One X, because there is a chance that you can enjoy your favorite original Xbox game on it. That's a solemn pitch right there, Microsoft. Now, since this console generation is using the same type of architecture as the x86 architecture on modern PCs, it is not that complicated to port games between this generation console and a PC compared to what it looked like before, where the situation was totally different and the consoles were using a different PowerPC architecture made by IBM, which made the porting between console and PC a lot more complex. Being able to play original Xbox games made 20 years ago and even Xbox 360 games on the new Xbox One required Microsoft to build a whole emulator into the Xbox One, which, if you think about it, is pretty impressive. If you have the latest Xbox, you can even play some 360 games in 4K. Now, this only works in a handful of titles, Halo 3 being one of them. It's really interesting to see Microsoft putting down so much work and effort into this, because I mean, sooner or later you gotta want to jump back into those old games and enjoy the nostalgia, and having that option on the Xbox One is pretty dope if you ask me. Also, the integration between Windows 10 and Xbox One is pretty interesting. I've tried the streaming feature a couple of times and it works better than I first thought. Now, how does this work? Simply make sure your Xbox One and your PC are hooked up to the same network. Start the Xbox app on your Windows machine and make sure you're logged into the gamertag you wanna use. Hit stream, wait a few moments, and you should see the dashboard. Since everything is being streamed, you should expect a small delay, though that isn't something that I've noticed. However, I don't recommend streaming fast competitors such as Fortnite for obvious reasons. Now, last but definitely not least, guys, there's something called Play Anywhere. Play Anywhere is a cross-buy program between the Xbox One and Windows 10, where supported games can be bought either on the Windows Store or the Xbox Game Store with a unique Xbox Microsoft account, and then the game will be available globally for the same for the account. Now, this only works for a handful of games, obviously, but there's a comprehensive list of supported games that can be found on the Xbox Play Anywhere website. That being said, I'm not totally convinced on the Windows 10 store. Microsoft simply needs more time and work here, and wouldn't it be better if you had the option to deciding for yourself where you wanted to play your Anywhere games? Because being locked down to the Windows store is a big no-no for many folks out there. But anyways, as you can see, there's plenty of reasons why you should consider the Xbox One X. For the time being, the Xbox One X remains to be the cheapest way into 4K gaming. Now, on this channel, I cover a variety of gaming related peripherals, tech console and PC components such as headsets, headphones, mics, monitors and so on. Recently, I listed the best budget gaming mice as well as the best mechanical gaming keyboards. Link to those videos can be found down below. With that said, who am I to talk about this? Well, first off, I've been a gamer since I can't remember. I'm a tech savvy and I worked in the gaming peripheral scene in the past. I also built and overclocked computers for 12 years and I've been a content creator for 3. Now, there's a ton of videos just around the corner for you guys. If you're looking for the best budget monitor, headset, keyboard, headphones, mousepad and more, consider subscribing. Also, don't forget to tap the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any uploads on my end. Thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Robin here on Chips Media. Until next time, guys, have an awesome day, all right? Bye.